We get a pair of perspectives now on some of these bigger issues that are being debated. Patrick Harker is president of the University of Delaware and a member of the board of directors of the NCAA Division I. And Kevin Blackistone is a panelist for ESPN and teaches sports journalism at the University of Maryland. And welcome to both of you.
Thank you.
Kevin Blackistone, let me start with you. Put aside for a moment specific cases or solutions. What's the overall problem you see in college sports
today? Inequity.
Inequity.
It's inequity in money. It's inequity in power. It's inequity in resources. The resources are what this unionization of Northwestern football players is all about. It's really not about compensation, but it's about things like health care, workers' compensation, protection of scholarships should they be injured and no longer be able to play. Most people in this country don't realize that scholarships are one-year renewable contracts with the university stamped by the athletic department. So if a player is hurt and he or she can no longer play, they can lose their scholarship. So it's really basic things like that, and it's really not very much about compensation in terms of hard dollars.
All right, let me ask Pat Harker. First, is the word crisis, do you accept that? What is the situation for college sports today?
Yeah, so if there's a crisis, I think it's a crisis in losing sight of the fact that the most important part of the phrase student-athlete is student. I mean, and I say that not just as a university president, but I say it as a former student-athlete. I'm here today because athletics opened doors for me. And I really worry that starting with middle school all the way through college, we've lost sight of the fact that students need an education to be successful. Even if they have a pro career, they're not going to do that forever. And after their career is over, they need another career. They need to be successful in something else, and they need an education.
Do you, staying with you, Pat Harker, is the very term student athlete a useful one? Is it one we should use or one we should discard?
Yeah, because if you think about the University of Delaware and most members of NCAA Division I, we lose money on athletics, substantial sums of money. But you have to think of it as a subsidy. We're subsidizing an opportunity for students, just like we do in the theater program, just like we do in the music program, in this case through athletics, to learn things they can't learn in the classroom and to provide for our community that sense of competition and camaraderie and pride. But if you lose sight of that fact, then I think there is a problem. I mean, we do this. We lose money on lots of things. We lose money on every student that comes to university. They're subsidized. But we do it because there's a greater purpose. We want to give them a great educational experience.
Kevin Blackistone, what do you think about the term student-athlete? Is it a misnomer? Is it useful? Should it be discarded?
It absolutely should be discarded, and it is a cover.
And
it is a cover. It was invented by Walter Byers. He admitted it in his confessional after running the NCAA for some 30-plus years. He invented it back in the 60s to provide the NCAA cover from having exactly what is happening today happen then. And that was to have student athletes looked at as employees. The member institutions and NCAA had faced a number of very serious lawsuits from players who had been critically injured on the field. And they wanted their member institutions to take care of them as if they were what they are, and that is employees of the university. And Walter Byers explains in his confessional that came out in the mid-90s called Unsportsmanlike Conduct, how he came up with this term and what he meant by it. So the phrase student-athlete, which we in the media have regurgitated, has given cover to the NCAA and its member institutions, not only in the court of public opinion, but also in legal court, too, when people have tried to challenge this notion.
Well, so, President Harker, when in saying that you think the student part of that is still the key, you argue against, for example, the idea of unions for athletes, for college athletes. Explain why you think that would be a bad idea.
Well, look, we lose money on every sport we offer at the University of Delaware and every school at our level. And so if we're required to spend more money and we're required to take our eye off the ball of giving these students a real education, then everybody loses. And we don't want to do that. And again, personally, as a former student athlete, where doors open for me because of that experience, I want to make sure this next generation has the same opportunities.
What about paying them, compensating them in any form? Is that possible?
Well, we pay them through their scholarship today, but only half of our students are on scholarship. Many, again, we often think about men's basketball and football, but there are many student athletes on campus to take advantage of this opportunity, some with scholarships, some without, but they're doing it for the love of sport and what they learn through that sport.
Kevin Blackistone, he's making an important point we often hear and sometimes forget. We focus on these big-time programs and these big-time sports.
Right.
And forget about everything else.
Well, right now there's an erosion going on within college athletics and has been for some time. And so the University of Delaware is one of the schools that is suffering the erosion. And sooner or later there is going to be, if there isn't already, a core of 50, maybe 60 schools, at least half of which do make profit off of their athletics, who are going to be controlling the sport. And so I think sooner or later, as we've seen through the formation of the BCS over the years, which in a new football contract playoff, which they were so opposed to just a few years ago, have decided to go forward and do it for $5.6 billion from ESPN, I think you're going to see those schools start to circle around the pile of money that they are able to generate and keep that for themselves.
And what harm do you see in that system?
Well, if that system continues, I think the harm is going to be to the schools that cannot participate in it. And we know that there has been an arms race, an athletics race over the years. Every year there's another school, another very small school, which plunks down a few million dollars to start up a football program. Why? Just because it brings marketing and public relations to your university, and also from the idea that maybe somehow you can make a buck off of this. And I think that that's the problem here. And so a union, once again, is really what these kids are talking about, really is not the compensation, but resources and power and a seat at the table with the NCAA so they can bargain for their own rights.
All right, so Pat Harker, just in our last minute, you can respond to that, but what kind of things, what would you like to see happen?
Well, first, remember, the conferences we're talking about, Kevin's talking about, are the exception, not the rule. We, right. Universities like the University of Delaware, are the majority of Division I. And so what I worry about is, in this conversation, we're letting five conferences, potentially through the media, drive the debate. For colleges at our level, I'd like to see, as I said earlier, a renewed focus on the student athlete. And that means not only their success on the field, but their success in the classroom, to make sure that they can get the major of choice. And sometimes we've set this up where it's a little difficult to do. We have geographically dispersed conferences where they're on planes or trains a lot. I think we need to start to create some consolidation at our level, geographic consolidation, so students aren't away from campus so much, so they can get that degree that involves a lab, that involves a research project. That's what I did when I was a student athlete, and that led me to the career I have today.
All right, Patrick Harker is president of the University of Delaware. Kevin Blackistone, thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.